Good afternoon, classroom.
What did you study yesterday in geometry? Yes?
Last time, we studied Thales' theorem.
Thales' theorem, and especially which theorem? The unit was the Thales' theorem. But what did you study? Yes?
Midpoint,
yes? Now, what is it, the midpoint of a line segment? What is the definition of the midpoint of a line segment? There are some students who didn't study the midpoint of a line segment here. Yeah? Now, what is it? What is the definition of the midpoint of a line segment?
The midpoint of a line segment is a point halfway the line segment.
Do you understand there?
Yes.
Can you repeat what did he say?
Yes.
Tell us, what is it, the midpoint of a line segment? Because you said that you understood, what did it say? What is it now, the midpoint of a line segment? Another one. Yes?
Midpoint is the halfway of the line segment.
So we said that the midpoint of a line segment is the point which is to the halfway of this line segment. Now, I want to know, if you have two triangles, when do we say that those two triangles are similar?
Yeah.
Even if I say that this one is similar to this one, what does it mean? Yes?
When the sides are equal.
When?
The side is equal on all sides.
When the sides have the same length, but we don't say that it must be an equilateral triangle. You had to add that the corresponding sides have the same length. Okay?
Yes.
In this case, we'll say that the two triangles are similar. Now, if I consider this figure here, have you got there, you can show two triangles which are similar. So it does not say that the corresponding sides have the same length, but they are proportional. Okay?
Yes.
Proportional to mean that they are in the same ratio. Now, on our figure there, have you got the similar triangles?
Yes.
Yes, come and show two similar triangles there. On this figure.
This one and this one.
Two triangles.
This one.
Show, find on this figure two triangles. You say this one and this one. Is it clear?
No.
Yes. Yes? Okay, you show that this triangle and which other triangle? Okay, we can clap for her. So those two triangles are similar. And as those two triangles are similar, if you use what we call the intercept theorem, it is asked to you, we give there the measures of the sides. Now it is asked to you to find the length of X and to find the length of Y using the intercept theorem. If someone can come and calculate X. Now before to calculate X, what is the length of this side according to which is marked there? Yes? You find, you can come and show how do you get those 6 centimeters. How? You count the points or the segments?
Segments. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Okay. Now from there, someone can come and calculate the length of X. Yes. You can do it here. You read on the triangle there. And you can explain to your classmates what are you doing, showing the figure there.
If I first find the put on ratio, it's a right 2 to 6, it's go to x over x to 5.
Now 2 to 6, where is 2 on the figure there? What is the first segment whose the length is 2?
The first one is this one, second one is this one.
Huh? The first one, there are 2 segments.
This one and second is this one.
So I want to know where is the segment whose the length is 2? And the segment whose the length is 6? Okay, continue now.
And we are going to find the segment of X here and this here. And when we have 5 segments, we count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Okay, calculate now X.
We are going to solve X. Right, because is this one you can think is division. Is we shall put 2/6. It's got X over 5. We do cross multiplication. Right, 2 times 5, put 6 times x, 10x, 6x, and we change 6x. Well, when we are going to solve value, we take value which is here, we put here, and take this one, we put here. 10. When we want to find x, we shall put over 6, because here we have 6x over 6. X will be, put 1, 6, 4, point, put 0. We put 6, x at 6. And we find here, we get the number is coming too many, and we put here some things here. 1.6 over.
Very good, you can clap for him. Another one can come and calculate why. The value of y now, yes? And there she gets that y is 1.2. You can clap for her. So it is like this as our introduction. Now you can form your groups and make the following activity. So in each group, you choose your team leader and the secretary. Now you can make this activity. During 10 minutes. I think that each group has a textbook. You can get your textbooks on the page 134, yes. Is the activity clear?
Yeah.
Work in the group. So first, you must draw the triangle according to the measures which are given there. And then so it is asked to mark the midpoint and so on. But who's the team leader of your group? You aren't doing anything, why? Huh? How is it possible? Thank you.
finished to draw the triangle?
Yes.
You're on which activity? And all the members must participate. Huh? No, you are to each other. We gave PQ.
Oh, you don't say it. It is 8.
Oh, is it clear there? So is 8. There 6, huh? Okay, we get PN. PN and NR. PN and NR. How are they? It is not PN and PR. PN and NR. Okay? Now, answer to the other questions. So there you are on the question C. Yes. Now, what is PN and NR? How are they? And what is the ratio of MN to QR? Yes. You are using the textbook, now you get it in your hands wide.
What are you?
Today. Number C. PN and NR. Okay. Now MN and QR. But you must look for this ratio. What is it? Not parallel is not a ratio. Parallel is a position. Yes. Now here. When you compare two numbers, we want to know if they are equal or they are different. Okay. Or even we can give the relation between them.
Yes.
What do you look at that? What do you look at? You see, when the rooms are with Texas.
Yeah, I'm going to do that.
This is the first activity, very good. We can clap for her. second group, come now and mark the point M, the midpoint of PQ. She used this side, 1 and 4. But when we said that we show with the classmates, we don't draw only, but we can tell them something. You understand? Yes? It is not the midpoint theorem, but it's theorem, yes?
Intercept theorem.
Intercept theorem. Now, using this intercept theorem, what is, when you compare PN and NR, how are those length segments? Another group, the next group. This group now, it is asking you to go and compare PN and NR. Also the intercept theorem. You can explain us how do you get your ratio there? So we make the sum. Yes.
Half of
And how do you get it? It is the half of QR.
According to the intercept theorem.
Yes, but here you write only MN is the ratio of QR. But how do you get this 1 over 2? It is from where? So I want to write, if it is possible, write this as a proportion, MN to QR. It is equal to which other ratio? Before to get this 1 over 2. In this triangle there. It is? What do you say?
7.2.
Where is 7.2? QR. Do you know the measure of QR? Is it given? Not. Now you will use which ratio? Yes. It is? 1 to 2. What is it? How do you get it? If you use the sides there, what is the segment you will use to get this 1 to 2? Place there. You get that MN is the half of QR, but how do we get it? Try to use the other ratios you have got on the sides there. You can use which ratio there. What did you get? PM to PQ, what is it? Now, PN to PR, what is it? Now, if it is asking you to complete this proportion, he said that it is MQ to NR. Is it like this if you use the similar triangles? Yes, another one can come and give him a hand. What do we say? So you said that it is, come and complete here. And from there, what do you get?
Yeah.
Now, you will get from there, so we get that M is the half of QR. Okay? Now, from now, B and C, it is asked to you to make the conclusion. And before to go to the conclusion, we gave here, it was asked to draw a triangle. This group drew this triangle. Okay? Second, it was asked to mark the point M, the midpoint of PQ. It is marked there. Number C, they draw MN parallel to QR with N on PR. It is drawn there. Now, it was asked
to find, to compare Pn to Nr, and also to find the ratio of Mn to Qr. Now, I want to know, in the third group, we got that here Mn is the half of Qr. Now, in your group, did you get the same? If there is a group who got something which is not this one, can come and tell to the share the findings of the group of the classmates. Now, it is asked to discuss now from B and C, what is the conclusion? This group, what did you get as conclusion? And this conclusion is about the statement of the midpoint theorem. What can be the statement of the midpoint theorem? And before to state this midpoint theorem, what are the two conditions that must be verified according to the activity there? You can come and share with your classmates the findings of your group about this line segment MN and QR. What did you get there? You can come and present your findings and share with your classmates. Okay, very good. Now we want to know what can be your conclusion now. If it is given to you a line segment MN which joins the midpoint of the of two sides of a triangle, what do you say about this midpoint and the third side? As conclusion, what did you get in your group there? Tell us, what did you get there? So we have a midpoint, a line segment MN joining the midpoint of the top two sides of a triangle. What do you say about this line segment and the third side? Yes? You can come and tell to your classmates. You show it from the figure there?
Side, outside.
You say? Rotate, yes.
The midpoint theory is the right segment joining midpoints of two sides of triangle which is parallel to the third side and half to its peak.
Do you understand what they say? Who yes. Can you repeat it for us? What did he say? Yes, you can repeat. Very well, you can clap for him. Huh? Yes.
Triangle is parallel to the third side and half its length.
So he says that if you have in a triangle a line segment which joins the midpoint of two sides, this line segment is parallel to the third and it is its half. And this is what we call the midpoint theorem. We clap for your classmates. This is the statement of the midpoint theorem. And you find it there are also what I found here. So exactly what did you find what you found there? So here we said that PN and NR have the same length as we wrote there. You wrote it here after drawing this triangle. Now we said that, so in our case we have no plenty there. We obtain also that the ratio is 1:2, and we get here that the reasons are given there. Now the conclusion, the midpoint theorem, we state as it is stated there, in a triangle the line segments joining the midpoint of two sides is parallel to the third side and half of this and the half of its length. So this is what you found also. You can if you want to take the notes, we can do this this assessment in your groups. You can make this exercise. Someone can read it? Someone can read it there? Yes? But you don't read this? DE. Now, according to which is given there, can you use the midpoint theorem? So you will discuss about it in your groups there, and now you can make this exercise.
Thank you. Thank you.
The white book is to six. That's why it is to six. Yeah, you have finished? Yeah, also you have finished. Now we can do the correction on the blackboard. We'll start by this group. Please, you can go and look for the... So here it is us to evaluate AE and here DE. And you explain to your classmates how do you get this AE, and another one will calculate DE. You can do it here. You explain to your classmates how do you get your solutions or your answers. A equals the half, right? Very good, can clap for him. Another one can come and calculate DE. DE, another one. DE. And then the right solution. Thank you. your notes, you will write the activity, and you write those suggestions, and this assessment and its suggestions. So let's get it from your notebook to take notes. So in your notebook, you will write Unit5 Thales Theorem, Midpoint Theorem, and now the activity, suggestions, assessment, and suggestions. What are you going to do? Huh? What is the matter? From what? From where? Go and sit down. Get your notebook and take the notes. What are you doing? So you have 10 minutes to take those notes. We will stop there with our lesson.
Thank you.
A and B are on the figure here. So A is, was to draw the triangle. B was to mark the point M. Okay? Now we'll stop there for today. We'll continue tomorrow.